Yes, who knew Fireball had so much to do with Halloween, right? We are getting into the Halloween spirit with some creepy cocktails that you can make at home. And joining us this morning is author of this book. It's called Cocktails for Cougars and Cowgirls. I love it. Jordan Catapano. Good morning, Jordan. How are you?
Good morning.
All the way from California. She's going to be signing books and talking this weekend. The BevMo and Chandler tonight, 5 to 7. Tomorrow morning, right over here at the Biltmore at the Pottery Barn from 11 to 1, just for starters.
Yes.
So how are you?
I'm doing great. It's really fun to be here, especially to make cocktails this early in the morning.
It's 5 o'clock. It has to be. We played the song earlier. It is somewhere.
Well, I wanted to share with you one of our most popular cocktails, which is called the Wicked Hot Cocoa.
Okay.
And what's special about it is it starts with not just your average hot cocoa mix. I mean, start with your favorite, but we add a couple spices that make it extra good. So in this, we have about a tablespoon and a half of hot cocoa mix.
Okay. And milk.
And a cup of milk.
Okay.
And a tablespoon and a half of sugar. And then a little dusting of cinnamon, some allspice and ground cloves to put in it, which is really yummy. It brings out all the spices, makes it your house feel like, smell like October.
It does smell good. I have a feeling the best is yet to come.
The best is yet to come, yes. Okay, so I'm going to pour this, which is nice and hot, into this cooled part of the stove. This is our hot cocoa mix.
All right.
And I'm going to put into my glorious Arizona coffee mug some Fireball whiskey.
Some Fireball. How much?
I guess that's up to your discretion. I'm going to put an ounce in for now.
Okay.
But you know, if you're feeling like you might need a little bit more, you can add a little bit more.
We're getting serious around here.
I'm going to add also an ounce of spiced rum.
Okay.
So we have 2 ounces right now of some yummy stuff. And then I will add my hot cocoa.
On top of that.
Yeah, all the way, almost up to the top.
Okay.
And then, of course, you cannot forget the...
Of course, the whipped cream.
Right. I like to leave a lot of space in the cup so you can fill it up, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're going to
fill this up. This is pretty easy.
It is really easy.
Gosh,
really
I wish I could try that.
But we call it Wicked Hot Cocoa because, you know...
For a good reason.
So let's top this with a couple sprinkles, and it's ready to go.
By the way, your book has dozens and dozens of drink ideas. Look at this one, and not so much Halloween, but it's called Banana Beach. I love that. You were a bartender once?
Yes, I was a bartender for many years in Los Angeles, and I was trying to write horror movies, and that didn't work out so well. But what did work out really well was writing cocktail books. So I've been a mixologist and a bartender for a while, and now an author. This is my third book, and we're really excited to be here in Phoenix signing books for people.
Yeah, it's great to have you here. The website, if you want to check out her other books, thisgirlwalksintoabar.com. I love that. The other two books are?
The first one is called This Girl Walks Into a Bar, A Woman's Guide to Professional Bartending for anyone who wants to get into bartending quickly. It's a really great book for that.
All right.
And then our second book is called This Girl Minds Her P's and Q's, and it's an etiquette book, modern day etiquette. So not your grandmother's etiquette, it's etiquette for people today. Go dining out, entertaining at home, things you need to know.
Okay, we all have our idea of what a Scottsdale cougar might be. What is your definition of a cougar?
My definition of a cougar is any woman who's maybe just 35 or older who's, you know, confident, sassy, hot maybe even.
Yeah.
But
well,
mostly
of course.
It's all confidence. That's what it comes down to. Whether you're a cougar or a cowgirl or anything in between.
All right. This drink looks fantastic. Oh, I wish I could take a sip right now. I just can't. But we can take a commercial, and I can, because the bosses will have no idea whether I did. If I come back like this, no, I swear I did not try the drink. No, I would never do that. Why would you even ask?
Quick.
What? Oh. We'll be right back.